Hello friends, welcome back. In this video we are going to study one more example of switch case, and it is menu driven program for arithmetic operations. Okay, before this actually in one video I explained how to perform all the arithmetic operations, but in that video or in that example how we perform that arithmetic operation, we performed it one by one. Now here how we are going to perform this arithmetic operation, we will accept two values from user. Okay, this will be our sequence. Accept two values. Then after accepting two values, we will accept option from user, and that option can be plus, minus, multiplication or division. Okay, now user will select any one option from this, or user will enter any one option from this. And according to the user option, we are going to perform arithmetic operation on our two values. Means, for example, if user says plus, then what we will do? We will perform addition of that two values and we will display the result. If user says minus, we will perform subtraction of that two values, and so on. So this kind of programs are called as menu driven program. Why? Because we are providing menu to our user. And from that menu, user can choose a single option. Okay. Now, how many variables are required here? See, at a time, only one operation is going to be performed. Either plus, minus, or multiplication or division. So, and that operations are going to be performed on your two values. So, these two values are your input. Then, You want to accept the option from user, that is plus, minus, multiplication, division. So you have to declare that option variable also. And you need one variable to store a result. Okay. Now here if I consider that my two values are of type integer, then addition, subtraction and multiplication result is also going to be integer. But my division result can be float. Okay. So for that I need one extra variable. So say x and y are my two values, okay, and z is my result, or say result, res is my result. And to store a quotient, I'll declare one separate variable, that is q, okay, and that will be for our division result. And one variable to accept option from user, we are going to accept plus, minus, multiplication and division signs from user. So that signs or symbols are nothing but what? Character type of data. So for that I need one OPT variable. You can declare any variable, choice, OPT, anything. Okay. So here I am declaring option, for option OPT. Okay. For option OPT. Now, how your program will be? So first of all, as I told here, according to our algorithm, what we will do? We will accept two values first. Now to accept two values, I have to use scanf statement, right? Now two values are of type integer, so that's why I wrote %d%d, and my two variables are x and y. So ampersand x and ampersand y. Now after this, what will I accept? I will accept option. Now my option is of type character. Okay, so I'll say scanf %c OPT. Now depending on this option value, if it is plus, then I will add these two value x and y. If it is minus, I will subtract these two value. Okay, so I have to keep my OPT variable in switch bracket, because I want to compare this OPT with my case values. Now what are my cases? See, now my OPT is of type character, so my cases are also of type character, and according to the rule, character constants are enclosed in single quote. So if it is positive or if it is plus sign, then what will I do? I'll add two values, that is x plus y, and whatever is my result, I'll print it here. Printf addition is %d, my result is in variable res, and then after break. In same way, you can write a case for minus. Okay, in the same way you will write a case for multiplication and division. And if somebody enters the symbol other than this, then we will say it is an invalid option. So this kind of programs are called as menu driven program, and in this program only one case is going to be executed, not all the cases. So I hope you understand why I declare this much variables. Okay, so let us write the program in code block. So here I already declare opt variable. Now let us declare our rest of the variables. Say int x comma y and result variable to store the result of addition, subtraction and multiplication. And to store the result of division, I'll use variable q for quotient. Okay. Now let us give a message to the user using printf. Enter two values. Okay. Now scan this value. Scanf. %d, because my both the variables are of type integer. So %x, %y. Now next is to accept the option from user. Printf. Enter option. Now scanf. %c, %opt. Now I want to check the value of opt here, so I'll put it in a switch bracket. Now switch curly bracket get start. Now let us write a cases. So case plus. Okay, since it is character constant, I have to enclose it in a single quote. Now let us perform the addition. So result is equal to x plus y. Now we will print the result. Addition is %d. And my result is in variable res. Now break. So what will I do? I'll copy this code, because it is going to be same for my minus case also. So I have to just change the sign here. So instead of plus, I'll say minus, and here also I will use subtraction operator. Let us change the message also. Now let us write the same code for multiplication. So my symbol will be asterisk and the operator is multiplication operator. And again message will be what? Multiplication. Now for division. Now here what I am going to do. See, whenever you are going to perform a division operation, how we are going to perform? We will say q is equal to x divided by y. Q is equal to x divided by y. But suppose if the value of y is 0, see, we cannot divide any number by 0. The answer is infinity. Even your computer cannot perform the division. So in that case, we have to compare the value of y first. If it is 0, we will display the message infinity. And if it is non-zero, then only we are going to perform division operation. So here I have to check a condition. So we will check that condition using if. So if y is equal to 0 means my divisor is 0. I'll show the message printf infinity, or you can say can't divide by 0 if it is non-zero. In that case I am going to perform a division operation. So I'll say q is equal to float of x divided by y. Okay, this is typecasting process. I explain this concept of typecasting in miscellaneous operators. So if you are not familiar with this, please watch the video of miscellaneous operators. Now I'll print the value of q. So quotient, quotient is %f. Now q is of type float, so q. Okay, now after else I want to execute two statements, that's why I included it in a curly braces. Now the purpose of including if else in case is that I want to tell you that you can use any control structure within any other control structure. Means inside switch you can use if, inside if you can use switch. Now this is not a case, if you are using switch case then you cannot use the other control structure. Definitely you can use other control structure and as many times as you want. Now the last case remains, what is it? Default, if somebody enters the value other than the specified symbols, then we will say printf invalid option. Okay, so let us run our program. Say yes. Now there is an error. So look at here. What is an error? Expected semicolon before curly braces token, means before this colon semicolon is missing. Okay. Now let us build it again. Yes. Now let me enter 5 and 6. Okay. Now as you can see, it never accepted option from user or from me. My program get terminated directly. Why this happens? Many times whenever you are accepting the character type of input, this time this error occur. So what we have to do? We have to clear our input buffer. Now what is input buffer? Input buffer means a part of memory which is reserved for input purpose. So always you have to clear your input buffer before scanning the character type of input. Now how to clear your buffer? Using fflush stdin. So using this you can clean your input buffer. Actually fflush is a function and here you will specify which buffer you want to clear. You want to clear stdin. Now stdin represents input buffer. Now let us try again. So since I made a change, I'll build and run it. So I'll enter 5 and 6. See, now it wait for accepting a symbol. Now I enter the symbol plus. See, addition is 11. So let us try for division. I enter 3 and I enter my divisor as 0. Now I enter option slash, that is for division. So it is showing me an infinity. Now, as you can see here, whenever I am executing a program, I'll enter a value. Yes, I am entering the value. Okay. But while entering an option, I should guide my user that what to enter or what are the options available for you. So you can display the list of options using printf. So let us display it. Okay. Your subtraction answer is also executing very well. So before accepting input from user, what we will do, we will display the available options to user. So using printf statement. So printf, so say plus for addition, then next option I am going to show on new line, so I will use slash n. Instead of writing one more printf statement, I am using slash n here. So minus is for what? Subtraction, again slash n, asterisk is for multiplication. So from this user can have an idea that what option has to be entered, and this slash is for division. So again we made a change in our program, so build and run it. Now entered 4 value. Sorry, I'll enter 2 value, 4 and 3. See, now these options are available for you. Plus for addition, minus for subtraction, and everything is appear on new line. I should specify slash n after division also. So my enter option part will appear on the new line. So I'll say asterisk. I want to perform multiplication. So multiplication is 12. Okay. So I hope you understand the program of switch case. This is called as menu driven program. This kind of programs are written in data structure also. So whenever you want to provide any multiple options to the user, then that program is generally solved with switch case and it is called as menu-driven program. So thank you.